Hi everyone, this is Cece and welcome to my channel. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. For today's video, we're going to pot the 6 big sizes of the succulents that we have unwrapped last week. So let's have a recap first of what are we going to pot today. So we have here the Alba Beauty, the Hero Wands, the Flagani, the Raindrops, the Heart Choice, I think, and the Benutsume. So I have already prepared the 6 pots that we're going to use, 6 new orange pots and 3 pieces of brown used pot. They are already filled up with used soil mix and topped with our Osmocote. And of course, let's not forget our top dressing, which is aqua soy. So let's start potting now. First, let's pot this Flagani. So this is my first time that I will be having this succulent in my garden. And let's cut the label or the succulent ID and put it in the pot so we won't forget the ID. But I'm going to replace it later. So temporarily, we're just going to tape it in the pot. And as you can see, the Flagani is so lush. It has a somewhat brown red tips. Also has farina. So all we have to do is put it in the pot and add soy mix gradually as needed. So I don't have a hard time of potting this Flagani because it's just only one stem and I did not trim the roots because the roots are okay. So let's press a little bit the soil mix and then let's top it with our top soil or top dressing, the aqua soil. This is how it looks like. So I'm using aqua soil as top dressing. So the purpose of the aqua soil for this as top dressing is to make it more beautiful when we pot it, and the other one is to prevent for the house bird to play with my soil mix or my pot of succulents, because whenever they see the rice hull, they keep on playing on it until the succulent is uprooted. So to prevent the birds from playing and to make our potting more beautiful, so I use aqua soil to make our potting more beautiful and to prevent the house bird from playing. And I'm having a hard time to maintain the drops in its leaves, so I wanted to try big size, so maybe I would be lucky to maintain the drops in the leaves. So that's my struggle with the succulent, to maintain the raindrops. Even though it is exposed in a rain or shine area, I cannot manage to perfect the raindrops and they are not getting bigger, although I put Osmocote fertilizer during their growing season last year. So the aqua soil doesn't help to promote root growth, but for me it is very useful to prevent the house bird from playing up with my pots of succulent, and also to make my pots more beautiful when it has a top dressing. It looks so clean and neat. So the third one that we're going to pot is a big size of Alba Beauty. It is an echeveria, so I wanted to clean up the echeveria first by cutting all the flower stalk that was cut, so there are still stems that was left. So let's cut it so we will have a clean echeveria to look at. So it also has a baby, and of course I'm going to trim also the roots. Then after trimming the roots, I will pot it. So echeveria are easy to pot. All you have to do is put it in the pot. So this Abba Beauty, it's big size but it's only a free from our seller. Thank you so much, Miss Hazel. So the seller of the succulents is Jusel San Cactolens. You can find or search in Facebook her page, or you can visit my previous vlog where I posted her FB page. So let's just add soy mix gradually and top dress it with our aqua soil. So the next one that we are going to pot is this succulent. Its name is Heart Drops. So maybe the drops will be heart shape when it is fully stable. So let's see in the future. So let's put temporarily the idea of this succulent in the pot so we won't get confused if it is mixed up with the other succulent that has also drops in their leaves. So it's easy to pot, just put it on top of the soil mix and add soil mix gradually. So for my new viewers or old subscriber, my soil mix is composed of 50% loam soil and 50% pumice stone. And I'm using in this video the top dressing aqua soil. So just like what I said a while ago, I'm using aqua soil as topping, not as a rooting hormone. Aqua soil as a toppings can add beauty to the pot of succulents, and as well as the main purpose of putting the toppings is that to prevent the house bird from playing on my pots of succulents. That is to cover the rhizal so they won't play on my pots. Let's go to the next succulent. This succulent is called Hero Wants Gold. I don't know why is it gold, but the color of this succulent is green. The leaf has farina and it has two big stems and one small. So let's put again temporarily the ID. So I'm tapping the pot now to make the soil go down, and then let's add a little succulent on the pot too. And then now it's time for us to top dress it. Thank you. So the last one that we're going to pad is what we call the Beni Nusume. So I have like this, but it's only a token size. So I remove also the flower stalk. As you can see, it doesn't look that good anymore because it doesn't receive enough sunlight. And it was in the box for, I think, 4 days. So eventually when it got its roots and it is well rooted, the set will look more nice. So Echeveria are easy to pat compared to the other kind of succulents, just like Graptopetalum and Graptopetalum. Because in my experience, I'm having a hard time of patting those succulents with long stem. They easily fall off. So what I do when I pat those kind of succulent is I use stone. Not like Echeveria, all you have to do is put it on top of the pot. So we're finally done. Let's take a good look of them. Enjoy watching. So that's all for today's video, guys. I hope you like my sharing for today. Thank you for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe and share my video to your family, friends, and relatives. Bye for now. See you on my next video. Bye. God bless us all. Bye.